Hi everyone, it's Karen here with a Mixed Media Altered Brush tutorial. Enjoy! I created this brush as a gift exchange with another online friend named Rina, and she created a brush for me, and I must tell you it is beautiful. And you can check out her video, it is linked here in the description area below, as well as a beautiful card that she made for me, and it's just unbelievable how beautiful her stuff is. She has an amazing YouTube channel and you should go and check her out. Her maritime themed brush was amazing and it inspired me to create her also a maritime themed brush. So I bought a 4-inch brush at the hardware store and I started altering it. The first thing I did is I gave it a really nice light coat of gesso. I just wanted a little bit of the whiteness to go on because I wanted to add some of the tissue paper above. To add the tissue paper, which is a Tim Holtz tissue paper, I took some matte medium. It's a fluid matte medium from Liquitex, and it's really thin and it's really easy to use and add tissue paper. I'm just adding tissue paper all around to just add a little bit of an interest to the brush. Having said that, if you'll notice at the end of my video, you will not really see the tissue paper in the front. You will only notice it in the back. And because it's a brush and it's gonna be hanging, I do like to also do the back of the brush because I just want it to look nice on both sides. However, you will not see the tissue paper after when I put it in the front because I've added, as usual, a lot of different embellishments and I just couldn't keep the tissue paper from not being hidden. So what I do is I put some matte medium in both sides of the tissue paper and then just add it on. And you can add it in many different ways because the tissue paper just goes on so smoothly. And because this is such a liquidy kind of fluid matte medium, it really goes on well. So I continued to add the tissue paper and wrapped it until I finished the whole brush. The next step is to add a little bit of netting. This netting I buy at my local craft store and it's just netting for, I mean, it looks like it's for fishing, but I think it's more for like flower, to decorate flower arrangements. But it's perfect because I love adding it to all maritime projects because it really makes it look like it's part of the ocean. Oh, it looks like a fishing net. And I am adding it both in the front and in the back. And as I said before, I mean, you will not see it in the front as much. You will see it from the sides and from the back, but it still adds a really nice texture. The reason why I'm adding it like this, I really at this point wasn't sure what I was going to do with it. I knew I wanted something maritime, but I really wasn't sure what I was going to do. So this is why I did that. And as you can see, I glued it all on both sides. And then I'm taking the white gesso again and just covering it all to make sure that the netting is all white because I wanted to create this really nice white effect in the background. And I'm doing both sides, of course, because I want the back to look really good as well. The link to how to buy this net and any other embellishment in this video is listed below in the description area. Now it was time to create the composition. And I chose a few embellishments that I thought would be nice. This is a resin frame from Prima and I'm adding it as my centerpiece. And then I chose a really big shell that I've had that I collected. I'm not sure if I collected this one. This looks like a one that I found because it looks really rugged. But, and I also have this Scrapinic chipboard piece that somebody sent me as a gift. And I've just basically started adding different things. I'm using the heavy gel to glue everything on the brush. And you could use any embellishments for this. This is a metal flower. It really doesn't really matter what embellishments. What I really want to show you is the technique that I use. This is a starfish. It's a real starfish. And I bought a bunch a while back. So I'm just gonna list those also in the description area to show you how to get them. and I added a few different shells. I got a really big shell container from one of the local stores, so I just, you know, have so many and I love using them in my projects, and it doesn't really matter what color the shells are. This is a little seahorse. This is a resin piece from Prima, and I'm not sure if it's still available, but I will find something hopefully similar. If not, I mean, it really just used any embellishment. And this little flower, this metal flower with the wings, that actually my friend Rina, the one who made me the brush, she sent me that embellishment. And sorry, I'm a little bit off screen here. I thought I was in the screen, but I'm not. This is a Imagine Ward. It's a wooden ward. It's from Heidi Swap. And I really, you know, it doesn't really matter what ward you use, what you use. It's just important to use something that you like. Here I switched the shell around and I added another metal piece that my friend Rina sent me. And this one was already like, you know, almost whitish, so it was really easy to alter. And finally I added an extra little shell in the center, which I don't show how I did it, but I just added an extra shell in the center. Now it was time to alter the paintbrush. And the first coat that I have to do is put some white gesso. This is Prima Finnabear Art Basics Heavy White Gesso. And I did two coats or maybe three coats of it. And you will be able to gauge it depending on how dark your embellishments are, how many coats you actually need to cover everything. So I am adding a really nice coat first, drying the first coat, and then doing a second or third one if needed. Once the gesso was dry, and you want to make sure that it's really dry, I started adding color. Now the key to this technique is to add the color not on top of the gesso, but in between the embellishments. So you're adding it, I started with Color Bloom sprays, and I took the Dragonfly Blue, which is one of my favorite colors, and I'm adding it and taking away. So you add a little bit and then you add and you spray with water to take away some of the ink, so you can still have that whiteness sticking out. So the best thing is to add it in between the embellishments or in the crevices of different embellishments, and then using water to kind of pull it all out. I'm also using the color Fern Needles from Color Bloom Sprays from Prima, because it's a greenish, beautiful greenish blue kind of color, and it really helps to have this maritime theme to it. So I'm going back and forth between these colors until I'm happy with the result. I'm also using Spring Dandelion, which is a beautiful yellowish kind of color. And that also adds, because when it mixes with the green and the blue, it creates a really nice rusty kind of look to the embellishments. For this technique to work, it's really important to add and remove ink. So you're spraying some of the color and then using either water or a wipe to remove some of it, so the embellishments stay white at the top, but the actual color goes in the crevices of all the texture and also in between the embellishment to add that shadow and that depth to the embellishments. Once I was done with my first layer, I dried it up. And then I started adding color again, but this time instead of spraying it, I actually dipped my paintbrush inside the jar of spray. And it's really important. You could use also the spout from the actual Color Bloom spray, but I find it easier to use a thin paintbrush. And I'm going between the different colors and adding them and washing my paintbrush in between. So what I'm doing is I'm adding it in the bottom part of the embellishment, at the underneath the embellishments, to really enhance that shadow. And it's basically the same technique as tape putting and removing, but it's just because I'm going straight into the tub of the Color Bloom spray, it really is concentrated ink and it really helps with adding that really nice dark shadow. Then once I add enough of that, I go in and will spray it again to kind of remove some of it, so it only stays in the crevices and in the shadows of the embellishments. This part of the embellishing and coloring takes the longest, because you really want to add and remove a lot of color in layers. So you have to dry in between and then add more layers. And I'm going between these three colors, I'm going back and forth, adding and removing until I'm happy with the results. And I'm really showing you the whole process. I don't want to cut this part of the video, even though it made the video a little bit longer. I really wanted to show you the whole process of how I did this to see how I'm adding and removing things from this, from the different embellishments. I also want to point out that the Color Bloom sprays don't have any fixative in them. So it's really important after you finish and drying your artwork that you actually spray it with some fixative. And I use the Prima Finabare Pixie Dust Fixative to actually cover everything and make sure that the color doesn't run. And I don't show this on this video, but any type of fixative would work. Once I was done adding the color, I wanted to add a little bit of that rusty feel that you see when you remove something from an ocean after being there for many years. So I took my red Prima Finabare Rust Paste and mixed it with a little bit of water because I wanted it to be watery enough that it would go in between the crevices but don't create such a strong color. So I took the same paintbrush that I used before. This is a Prima Finabare paintbrush and it's the thinnest one. And using it in between the crevices and then spraying with water, I did the same technique I did before with the spray, but this time using the paste. So not only it added that texture that these pastes have, but it also added that beautiful rusty color. And I'm going in different areas, just adding it and creating that beautiful rust effect in between the embellishments. As an added embellishment, I took a little glass vial and used book paper to create a little message in a bottle kind of embellishment. I stained the paper with the same rust paste from before, just added a little bit of it and just stained it to make it look old and then dried it up. Then I rolled it and put it inside the actual glass container and then using some heavy gel from Prima, I glued it in the spot that I wanted it to be. Then, to just make it match the rest of the background, I used some gesso and some of the spray and rust paste to just basically bring it all together. So as you can see, with all the embellishments that I added, you really can't see the tissue paper and the netting. But if you actually turn the brush around, you can actually see everything really well. So maybe I should have not added it, but I had a different idea and then this took me in a different tangent altogether. So that's okay, that happens sometimes and that's normal when you're creating. But I'm really happy with the results and the way this brush turned out. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked my video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends on social media. For more inspiration, subscribe to my channel and visit me on my website. Bye!